The last of Israel's founding fathers made his final journey from the Knesset in which he had served so long to Mount Herzl National Cemetery. Shimon Peres had earned his place here long ago. It seemed this day would never come, that Peres himself, at 93 years old, would live forever, and that made it so much harder to believe. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu remembers the day Peres cried at the funeral of his brother. Today, it was the world that weeps for Peres.
Shimon lived a life of purpose. He soared to incredible heights. He swept so many with his vision and his hope. He was a great man of Israel. He was a great man of the world.
Peres wasn't just part of Israel's history. He was, more often than not, its author. His significance extended far beyond the borders of his tiny country. World leaders thanked him for his wisdom, his optimism, and perhaps most of all, his hope. President Bill Clinton considered him a dear friend.
Someone who listened to, learned from, and laughed with him, and always was in awe of his endless capacity to move beyond even the most crushing setbacks in order to seize the possibilities of each new day.
Though there were so many world leaders here, Peres was the giant. He wanted this song at his funeral, Avinu Malkeinu. It means, our father, our king. It speaks of compassion, of mercy, for this generation and the next. So many spoke of Peres' dreams. He had such visions, but he worked to make his dreams happen. President Barack Obama compared him to some of the other greats of modern history.
In many ways, he reminded me of some other giants of the 20th century that I've had the honor to meet. Men like Nelson Mandela, women like Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth, leaders who've seen so much, whose lives span such momentous epochs.
Peres, in a simple wooden coffin, was led to his final resting place on Mount Herzl. His son had once asked him what he wanted written on his headstone. Peres responded, died before his time. Oren Liebermann, CNN, Jerusalem.